Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillah alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ba'd. So this is part 6 and today it is verse number 1 of surah number 5, surah al-ma'idah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala begins this beautiful surah by saying, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu awfu bil'uqood. O people of iman, fulfill your contracts and your agreements. Now, this particular verse here, it's not just about written agreements. It's not just about verbal agreements. It's also about agreements that culturally and socially and even legally that we're binded and we're encouraged to follow, that we should respect and follow as well. Now, the thing that needs some explanation is the cultural and social agreements that we have. It just because it's not explicitly written out for us in the Qur'an or in the Sunnah doesn't mean that we can do whatever we want. So an example of this is reserved parking. Reserved parking, every so often I'll get Muslims asking me, did the Prophet ﷺ ever tie his camel in one particular spot near the masjid? And it's like, it's a very immature and silly and definitely not even close to an intellectual conversation. It's just a very silly, quick way to try to get a point across that doesn't even make sense anyway. So the first principle to understand is that everything in this world is permissible and halal unless there is an ayah or hadith that tells you otherwise. So having reserved parking is halal and absolutely permissible unless there's an explicit ayah or hadith to say it is haram. And so the reason why I bring this up, I mean, there's so many different examples, like reserved seating, for example, and having sections in the masjid where you have the elderly sit together, people who are sitting in chairs and wheelchairs, they can be together. You can organize how people stand and pray. You know, the sick and the elderly are one place, and maybe soon when the lockdown is over and inshallah we're back in the masajid, we're going to have, you know, social distancing type setup for prayer and Jumu'ah and so on. So the organization is going to be different. Nobody can come and say now that, oh, the Prophet ﷺ never had social distancing, or we shouldn't be praying like this because the shaitan now is between us and blah, blah, blah. None of this makes sense. This ayah is saying, awfu bil'uqood, fulfill your agreements, that if culturally or socially people do certain things and it doesn't go against the Quran and Sunnah, then we should respect that. Now let's start the verse. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. How do you fulfill agreements? How do you fulfill promises? How do you complete contracts? The first ingredient, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Not ya ayyuhal nas. O people of Iman, not O mankind. O mankind, and for all of mankind to fulfill agreements and so on, that comes a little bit later, and there are several hadith that talk about that. This particular ayah is only towards Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu. Why? The first ingredient that if you want to ensure that you fulfill every agreement and every promise is you have to have Iman. Iman is the thing that makes you complete a transaction honestly. Iman is the thing that allows you to not cheat somebody, not trick someone. You know, you put things in fine writing that you know they can't read and used wordings that you know the average reader can't understand. It's just like every page of ingredients on a particular item. You go to the grocery store, try reading the ingredients on any item. It's almost impossible to read it on any single item. This is a marketing technique that companies around the world use. Why? Because, I mean, either they don't want you to know exactly what's in there, or if you're going to try to figure it out, then just kind of put you on a goose chase, right? So you're going to sit there, you're going to type these words into the internet, you're going to figure out what they mean, what they're talking about, then you're going to try to go and see what it does to your body and then figure it all out. I mean, who has time to do that, right? So just buy the product. As long as it's here, you're thinking it's been approved, it's healthy, or at least it's good enough to eat, so I'm just going to buy it and eat it. And so these are all techniques that are used. But when you have Iman, you don't care about any of that. You just care about doing the right thing. You know, about a year ago, I was walking in the mall and I saw a $100 bill on the floor. $100 bill. This is in Toronto. So everybody who lives in Canada in this part of the world, you know what $100 is, right? I mean, it's a lot of money. You could do a lot with that. And I saw a $100 bill. I waited. I didn't pick it up right away. I stood there and I looked at this thing, and it was so easy. In a split second, I could have just gotten down, pick it up, drop it in my pocket, keep walking. No one would have seen a thing. And I just waited there and I looked at this $100 bill, and I started to look around to see if somebody was looking for something, if there was somebody going through their purse or looking into their wallet, checking their pockets. I wanted to see if somebody realized that they had lost their money. As I'm looking around, this one dude is running behind me, ducks down, grabs the $100 bill, shoves it in his pocket, and keeps on running. And he's gone. And the fiqh ruling behind things like that is a separate issue. It's pretty simple and straightforward, but I just wanted to ensure that the owner of this money was wasn't close by. Then I could at least say, "Hey, did you lose something? Think it's right here." But before I could do that, somebody saw an opportunity and ran with it. When you have iman, you don't ever do that. And it could be the most minuscule of things, the most tiniest thing ever. You know, we all have, those of us who have kids, you know, when you walk into a store, lots of candies and treats and toys and so on. I can't tell you the amount of times my son walked into a store, and every now and then he'll pick up a lollipop and he'll ask me, like, "Daddy, can I have a lollipop?" And I'll tell him, no, we have lots of sweets and junk food at home. We don't need any of that." Not realizing that my son didn't even put the lollipop back on the shelf. You know, so here we are, we go to the cashier, we pay. He's still got the lollipop in his pocket. Then we'll walk outside and we'll go, and then we're sitting in the car, and before you know it, he pulls out a lollipop. And I'm like, "I told you to put that back, and you have it here with you?" When you have iman, you take the lollipop, you walk back into the store, and you let the store owners know, "My son walked out with this. He didn't touch it, he didn't do anything. I'm here to just return it." And you do that because that's the integrity, that's the honor in doing the right thing. Even if it's something as trivial as a lollipop, ya ayyuhalladhina amanu have to be leaders in ensuring that they fulfill agreements and contracts with one another. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala narrows down what he's referring to. Awfu bil uqood, fulfill your uqood. Uqood is one of a few words in Arabic to describe agreements. You have ahdun, you have aqdun, you have different names and terms to describe different types of agreements, depending on what that agreement is and what it's used for. In this particular ayah, Allah says uqud, which is plural for aqdun. Aqdun come it literally means to tie a knot, and that's why our belief system is called aqidah, because it ties us to our connection and relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's called our aqidah. So aqdun here, Allah is saying, is that it's a binding agreement, meaning if you belong with a particular system, you see a red light, you follow the red light, and you do what the red light tells you to do. Just because there aren't any cars doesn't mean you get to drive right through the red light. I mean, this happens very regularly here in Toronto, and especially because of lockdown, less traffic, less cars on the road. I can't tell you the amount of times, I'm sure many of you watching this, how many times you're sitting at a light or you come up to a stop sign, but there's not one single person around you, there's not a single car, it's in the middle of the night, and you're like, "Why am I stopping? I should just keep going. I mean, it's not like anybody's gonna see me." Yeah, that's the problem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you, and you are ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. So you wait until the light turns green. You stop because that's the law, and you do that. And this is why the ulama tell us that for a believer, if there was no leadership wherever they're living, if the leadership had just collapsed or there were no laws and no regulation, for the believer, there is always law and regulation. Why? Because you're ya ayyuhalladhina amanu. You make sure that you do the right thing. You know, unfortunately, because of this whole George Floyd killing that's happened in the States, obviously lots of protests, but along with those protests, I mean, I'm sure a lot of you have seen this as well. I saw a few videos yesterday online of guys doing live feeds of people looting. And one guy was actually doing a live feed in front of like a sports apparel store, and people were running in and out by like the dozens, dozens of people in and out, literally just stealing goods. You know, walking out with pairs of sneakers and shoes and sports apparel, just coming out with it as much as they could carry. I mean, they're dropping this brand new merchandise on the floor, but as much as they could carry, dumping it in their car. And the dude who's holding the phone and recording all of this, he's giving everybody props. He's saying, yeah, man, you keep going. All right, you got what you're looking for. So that what does that have to do with the message? To stand up against racism, to stand up against police brutality, to stand up and honor and stand up to grieve and send a message to the world of the wrongful killing of this young man. Like, what does that have to do with anything? So the violence, the looting, the damage, all of these things have nothing to do with the message. When you're Ya ayyuha alladhina aminu, you don't even steal an item, brand new item that's sitting right in front of you on the floor. Somebody drops their phone, somebody drops something. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu tries to find out where that came from. And subhanAllah, this is what the world is missing today. One of many things in the business world when it comes to just, you know, making money and doing business with one another is just that whole sense of complete, explicit, pure honesty. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is referring to. You have this binding agreement with people. Ya ayyuhallazina amanu awfu bil uqud, that ties you together with everyone. And it keeps you synchronized, keeps society harmonized, peaceful, safe. That everybody can respect each other's businesses. You know, at the end of the day, all the looting and the damage and all of these things, the vandalizing that's going on, most likely the people that are responsible for doing that are the ones that are going to end up paying to fix those things. Right? They're going to end up paying to clean up those streets. Now, I know that on the flip side, that there are many people that are very innocent from doing that. That they are there peacefully to send their message across of the wrongful killing of this young man. But at the end of the day, those that are responsible, they have to really, really search deeply within to realize, what exactly am I doing? Like, this is just wrong. I shouldn't be doing this. I shouldn't be taking from innocent people, people's businesses. I shouldn't be doing any of that. What's not mine is not mine. And that's what الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْفُوا بِالْعُقُودِ is all talking about. And so the one ingredient that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is teaching us in this ayah and several others as well, is that if you are in any sort of agreement, and the lasting example that I want to mention because it's so important is marriage and divorce agreements. Just because her dad is not there, just because his parents are not around, just because no one sees, doesn't mean you get to abuse each other's rights. Doesn't mean you get to say what you want as long as it stays within the house. That you get to abuse one another and say things and take things and be dishonest with one another in whatever capacity. Doesn't mean you get to treat each other that way. Doesn't mean that just because a divorce happens, now they've suddenly become your enemy. You know, such a thing as a peaceful divorce is almost like a taboo. Like, what are you talking about? Those two words don't go together, peaceful and divorce. How is that even possible? In Islam, tafriqum bil ihsan, that you separate based on ihsan. We talked about ihsan in the previous video when we were talking about wabil walidaini ihsana. And ihsan, again, starting point when you're being respectful to parents. It's also the starting point when a divorce happens, is that you divorce based on ihsan, righteousness. Like, that's unbelievable. It's almost impossible to fathom the idea that, you mean we're supposed to actually divorce and still be nice to one another? And we're supposed to do that peacefully and quietly? No. I'm taking him to court. No. I'm going to make sure that she never gets married again. So I'm going to make sure that I ruin her entire life. I'm going to make sure that he takes care of me and the kids and my family and everything. I'll take his car, his house, his money, his bank account, his job. I'm going to make sure I do everything to destroy his life. وَتَفْرِيقٌ بِالْإِحْسَانِ means nothing anymore. And that's what يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْفُوا بِالْعُقُودِ. It's a very powerful statement. Last thing that I'll mention is that why didn't Allah just say يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ, O mankind, fulfill your agreements? Because it's a responsibility of all human beings. Yes, it is. That comes later on. But in this ayah, Allah is talking about who should be the leaders, who should set the tone and the example of being leaders when it comes to doing the right thing and fulfilling each other's agreements and promises and contracts. It's alladhina amanu that motivates and pushes you to do that. Which what we're, the last thing is that what we're also learning is iman is not just restricted to a spiritual inner feeling, or it's not just something that's restricted to the heart. Iman is in actions. Iman is in speech, in words. But in this ayah, iman is also just in dealings with one another. Iman has to manifest to the way that we act and treat one another, even when we agree with something that isn't verbalized. It's culturally or socially acceptable that people do this. It doesn't contradict Allah's rules. It doesn't contradict our religion. So follow it and respect it. So yes, the next time you do see the reserved parking sign, respect it. Why? Because Allah said, "Awfu bil uqud." You're a person of iman. Respect the laws. Respect the rules. Respect the choices. It's not going against Allah's religion, so respect that. Well, even though when her dad is not around, respect her and fulfill her rights. Even though his family is not around, treat him well and respect his rights. All of these things, it makes life so much easier. And as how we started this short reminder, everything in this world is permissible unless there's an ayah or a hadith to say otherwise. So when you carry that principle with you and you take يَا يُلَذِينَ آمَنُوا أَوْفُوا بِالْعُقُودِ, subhanAllah, it's incredible how quickly you change the perception and opinions of people. Society can drastically change quickly just because people respect each other's property and each other's promises and agreements. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength to always be able to do that. This is a part of our faith. It is a part of our iman to ensure that we fulfill promises with one another. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the strength to do that. Jazakumullahu khairan, everybody. I hope that you could benefit from this short reminder. I know I do. I hope that all of you as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you all protected and safe, ayna ma kan, wherever you are. Allahumma ameen. Jazakumullahu khairan, everyone. Until we meet again, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.